Welcome everybody. My name's Cameron Guy and I'm going to be sharing my testimony for the glory of God tonight. And what I'm going to be talking about tonight takes a lot of courage because I'm talking about my sin and what I was doing and being sinful. And the thing is, I gave my life to God around about 11 years of age. And that would have been somewhere in Queensland, in a suburb of Queensland called Inala. And I believe the church was Assembly of God's because being young then, we were going to the youth group and things like that. And I'll be talking about that a little bit later to you, what happened at the youth camp and stuff like that. But the first thing I want to get into is I want to pray at the moment to allow the Holy Spirit and allow the Word of God. And I want God to be spoken tonight, and I want God to be using us as a vessel of God. And I'm just going to pray and ask for God's guidance and ask God to guide us in me sharing my testimony tonight. Lord Jesus, I just ask you to come to me, to minister to me, and to minister to everybody in the audience, Lord Jesus, and everyone in this church, Lord Jesus. I want you to ask, Lord Jesus, to let your Holy Spirit talk to everyone tonight. Lord Jesus, as you bring down your Holy Spirit on everybody tonight, that they will take home a message, Lord Jesus, a message that they can take home and share with other people, Lord Jesus. Thank you in the name of Jesus. Just let your Holy Spirit come in this church tonight. Lord Jesus, let the Holy Spirit wander around this church tonight and minister and to get into people's hearts and burdens people's heart and put a fire in people's heart that they will take home some sort of message tonight that they can say, well, if this is what's happened to this person, this can happen to me, God, that I can be a bright light. I can be this lamp shining for you, Lord, tonight. I just ask your Holy Spirit and God to guide this sermon tonight and let your voice be heard. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you in the name of Jesus. Amen. So what I'm going to start off with tonight is it's a bit strange because I'm going to talk about my testimony and about where I've gone in life. And what I'm talking about tonight is one question. What is sin? What is it to be sinful? And where I want to go with this is in Romans 7:25. So we're going to all turn our Bibles to Romans 7:25. And in Romans 7:25, we're going to be talking about Romans 7:25. Thanks to be God through Jesus Christ our Lord, so that when then I myself in mind am a slave to God's law, but in a sinful nature a slave to the law of sin. So when I was, as I said, I gave my life to God when I was only about 11 years of age, praise God. But still, somehow I was leading a sinful life. I was leading a sinful life. So as the scripture says in Romans 7:25, I was not a slave to God's law, which I'm now a slave to God's law. But in a sinful nature, which I was in, I was a slave to the law of sin, a slave to the law of to this world. And it's only taken as I've got older to realise that the things that I'd done in my life earlier, and it's only made me realise now, praise God, that I want to be a slave to God and I want to bring in a harvest to God. And when we look at the definition of slave, we're not talking like the slaves in Egypt or the slaves in Africa or any slaves in any other country. We're not talking about a slave like that. We're not talking about where you lose your freedom and you lose your human rights. No. God's not talking about that sort of slave. He's not talking about you becoming a slave where your life is 100% taken over by God. God's saying, well, you still have a life. But you, what God's talking about being a slave there is what I am doing now, is testifying, living what the will of God, reading your Bible, praying every day. Because if you were a slave, the definition of slave, if you're a slave, then you wouldn't have a job that you'd go to Monday to Friday, and you wouldn't have a life, you wouldn't have an extended family, you wouldn't have a family. No, we're not talking about that sort of slave where you lose all your rights, because God's not saying that, but God's saying that you've got to walk in God's light, read your Bible every day, pray, come and worship at church, and do the will of God. That's just my interpretation of that. Everyone's going to have a different opinion. And so, if we can also go to Romans 8, and see, in Romans 8, so everyone turns to Romans 8, verse 5 and 14. Those who are controlled by a sinful nature cannot please God. You, whoever are controlled not by the sinful nature, but by the Spirit. And if the Spirit of God lives in you, and if anyone does not have the Spirit of Christ, he does not belong to Christ. But if Christ is in you, your body is dead because of sin, yet your spirit is alive because of righteousness. So, in other words, in my case, sharing my testimony tonight, my spirit of righteousness was still alive in me. But because I was doing things of a sinful nature, because I was being sinful, that part of me was dead. But I could not see the spiritual righteousness that was alive in me. And as I go on in my testimony, as we're looking at verse 9 and then verse 10, but if Christ is in you, your body is dead because of the sin, yet your spirit is alive because of the righteousness. My spirit was alive because of the righteousness, and because at an early age of 11 years of age, I'd also accepted Jesus into my life at 11 years of age, and then shortly after that I accepted the Holy Spirit. Not a few years after that I've accepted the Holy Spirit into my life. It wasn't long after being born again that I've accepted the Holy Spirit into my life. But does that make sense to everybody? You can go and sin in this world and you can say, well, I'm a Christian. That's because that's what you're believing. But are you actually doing what God says? Are you a doer tonight? Or are you a sayer where you're saying, well, you go around saying you're a Christian. You believe that the righteousness in you, the righteousness in you is alive. But you are dead because you are living a sinful life. And this is what I was doing. I was a street kid. I was involved in illegal activities. I was involved in things that adults should have realized that it was wrong to do to somebody that was a juvenile. At the end of the day, it has taken me so long. I'm 36 years of age now. But as it goes on to say in verse 11, and if the spirit of him who raised Jesus from the dead is living in you, he who raised Christ from the dead, he also gave life to your mortal body through his spirit who lives in you. He gave our mortal bodies through his spirit who lives in you. Therefore, brothers, we have an obligation that it is not to of the sinful nature to live according to it. So it's not according to the sinful nature to live according to sinful nature. I have to stop it there. We'll get back to part 2 in 2 seconds of my testimony about my life.